Welcome. The following video gives you a quick overview of how the PISA-B electronic circuit breaker works. Before we start operating, please note the following warning instructions. Read the installation manual for detailed warnings. When setting up the PISA-B, minimum installation clearances of 40 mm on top, 30 mm on the bottom, and 5 mm on the left and right side are needed. In case the adjacent device is a heat source, you need 15 mm lateral clearances. Between multiple PISA-B modules, no clearance is needed. Ensure that the main supply is switched off before working. Also, please take note of the following installation hints. Pay attention to ambient conditions and installation clearances. Mount the device on a DIN rail according to EN60715 with the input terminals facing upwards. Please use suitable cables. The minimum and maximum diameters can be found in the installation manual or in the datasheet. Check that all ferrules are properly inserted into the terminal connections. We start with a brief overview of the front of the PISA-B device and its two modes. One for measuring in percentages, and the other for setting parameters in amperes. The device also has a set button that can be used in combination with one of the channel control buttons to make the relevant settings. It also comes with a handy feature to lock the device, protecting your current trip settings and characteristics. So on the LED matrix display, you'll see your measurements, chosen settings, and any errors that come up. You can decide whether you would prefer to have the display in percent or in parameters. To do this, press the set button and the fourth channel control button at the same time. You can now specify which display you would like. We are now in parameter mode and see our settings in amperes. As the measurement mode is more intuitive, we quickly switch back to it. Now let's have a look at the different configuration options of the PISA-B. We start by checking the present nominal current settings. All settings can be adjusted either in measurement mode or in parameter mode. It makes no difference which mode is selected. To check the settings for the output currents and tripping characteristics, briefly press the set button. The display shows the set output currents in ampere, and then the tripping characteristic with the letter F or S. Remember, this setting applies to all output channels. This function ends automatically after 5 seconds. When you receive the devices, they are all supplied with factory settings depending on the product you have ordered. You can find these settings in the datasheet. Now let's have a look at how to switch a channel on or off. To switch the state of a channel, briefly press the related button, for instance 1. Here we change channel 1 from on to off and backwards. If the LED appears red, it means the channel is deactivated, then it's off. When the LED is green, it indicates that the channel is active, so it's on. It is also possible to switch several channels off or on. For example, you can switch off channel 7 and 8 and leave 1 to 6 switched on. You can also switch all channels off or all on. We continue with selecting the current limit of each channel. Here's how you can adjust the tripping currents. When you receive the devices, they are all supplied with factory settings, and here the tripping set point per channel is 1 amp in fast tripping and measurement mode. Remember that you can change these settings regardless of whether you are in measurement mode or parameter mode. To adjust the set current, just press and hold the set button for at least 1 second. You'll notice the green LED with the letter A starts flashing. Simply press the button to adjust the current. For example, you can set channel 1 and 2 to 12 amps. Then channel 3 and 4 to 10 amps. 5 and 6 to 8 amps. And lastly, channel 7 and 8 to 6 amps. Once you have reached the required values, press and hold the set button a little longer to save the setting. Now that the LEDs have stopped flashing, it means the device has successfully saved the settings. This mode will stop automatically after 10 seconds if no more buttons are pressed. Now let's move on to select the tripping characteristic of the channels. There are two types of tripping characteristics. By delivery, the fast tripping characteristic is selected, but you can change it to a slow tripping characteristic. To change the tripping characteristic, press the set and the third channel control button at the same time. The chosen characteristic will light up on the LED display for 2 seconds and will be saved automatically. F stands for fast and S for the slow tripping characteristic. We quickly check whether our settings have been saved. Looks good. To keep your tripping current and characteristic settings safe from changes, you can use a PIN code. To lock the settings, just press the set button and channel control button one together until you see the text "PIN to lock" scrolling across the LED matrix display. Then enter a 4-digit PIN by pressing any combination of channel control buttons 1 through 8. For example, 1, 3, 5, and 8. Press the set button again to save the PIN, and you'll see locked scrolling across the display. Now the display for setting the output current limit is locked, and you will see the text locked when you press the set button, as these settings are now protected by the PIN. To unlock the settings, press the set button and button 1 together. The LED matrix will display PIN to unlock scrolling across. Enter the 4-digit PIN you chose earlier, and confirm it by pressing the set button. If you enter the wrong PIN, the LED matrix display will show wrong PIN. You'll need to try again and enter the correct PIN to unlock the device. And then you can see the text "unlocked" at the display, and you can adjust the current tripping set point of the output channels. Note that after making changes to the settings, you must set the PIN again to relock the device. Great, now you know how to lock your settings. Let's take a look at the maximum current tripping set point of the output channels you can set for each channel. It's important to know that channels 1 and 2 can be set up to 12 amps, while channels 3 to 8 are limited to a maximum of 10 amps. To clarify, I'll show you how channels 1 and 2 allow you to go beyond 10 amps, while for channels 3 to 8, once you reach 10 amps, they start again at 1 amp and cannot be set to 12 amps. First, we need to press the set button to enter the mode where we can adjust the tripping set point for each output channel. So if we look at channel 1, you'll see that once we go above 12 amps, we can start from 1 amp again and increase back up to 12 amps. The same goes for channel 2. Now looking at channel 3, you'll notice that after reaching 10 amps, it starts again with 1 amp and can only go back up to a maximum of 10 amps. Alright, so now you know that channels 1 and 2 can handle a maximum load of 12 amps, while channels 3 through 8 can handle up to 10 amps each. And that's it, a short overview of the different operations of the PISA-B. Thanks for watching. For more, check out our PULS channel or our website.